Hi, I'm Michael with Pride Roofing.
I'm Little Alex.
Have you been affected by wind, hail, and tornadoes on the North Shore? Well, we're here to help.
Insurance claim, no problem.
We also have a new franchise location in New Orleans. Remember to call us at 855-PRIDE-16.
Well, Joy Dominick, the director here at the Florida Parishes Juvenile Detention Center, had a great meeting. Lots of sheriffs, police chiefs, judges, you name it, local officialdom dependent in this five parish area on having this center open as a place to bring children accused of a crime. And frankly, I mean, if we didn't have this, a lot of those kids would be on the streets.
Yes, Ken, we were very honored to have all the stakeholders, sheriffs, judges, parish presidents, all coming out in support of the renewal of the tax for this detention center. And it's renewed every 10 years. It's a 3-mil tax. But without it, we wouldn't have a detention center. And it's a vital part of public safety in our community.
We have seen the areas that don't have a jail and what they go through with the criminal justice system. As a microcosm, if we didn't have this place, you would be facing a tremendous expense for local government. And frankly, I think a lot of these kids would just be set free.
I know about that firsthand, having been up at the legislature for the past couple weeks when the special crime session was running. I talked to a lot of colleagues in other parts of the state. We have 64 parishes. There's only 13 juvenile detention centers. So you could do the math. There's a lot of parishes that do not have a place to put kids. And they find themselves in situations like shipping kids out of state to places like Alabama, Mississippi, and the cost for doing something like that is astronomical if you were to spread it over a longer period of time and have your own facility.
Matter of fact, I mean, I've heard, I can hardly believe some of the numbers, like $3,000 a month to house a child.
That's an accurate number, but more than likely, a lot more than that. It takes anywhere from $320 to $350 a day to house a youth in placement. We're doing that for a lot cheaper out at the Juvenile Detention Center, but it's not always about the dollar. But when you have kids going out of state because you don't have a placement local, that's not beneficial for the kid, the family, or the tax dollars.
Well, it's clear you won't have any opposition to the tax renewal, but that doesn't mean you can take it for granted, because we've seen across the Florida parishes, I mean, a library tax that just barely got renewed in another parish, a health unit tax defeated in another parish, courthouse maintenance tax in St. Tammany defeated. Sometimes, you know, we're in a definite taxpayer revolt around here.
Yeah, we are, but, you know, I don't go get my tax bill at the end of the year and look at it and say, wow, I love paying taxes. Like, who likes doing that? I think we have to look at what makes sense, what's important to us, what's important to the voter. And when you have a detention center that is the only place for law enforcement to bring youth that are arrested and need to be locked up, I mean, that's the fact of the matter. It's the only place. And it's your right to not vote for something like that. But I think the reason we have a modern society with great infrastructure and great public services is because they're funded by taxes. It's a necessary evil. But I think it goes back to the voters on voting what matters to them and what makes sense in the community.
Plus, a tax bill, when you look at it, 10 mils for a recreation district, nothing wrong with that, and 5 mils for mosquito spraying, nothing wrong with that, but 3 mils for the detention center. That's not, if you have a high tax bill, it ain't because of that.
No, it's not. We're probably the lowest amount on the tax bill. And the reason for that is we're a juvenile justice district that was established by an act of legislation that comprised the five Florida parishes. And when you put that many voters and households together to fund a tax, you can keep the tax rate very low because you're spreading it across so many citizens and so many areas.
So you're definitely not following the traditional strategy to renew a tax by keeping it quiet. You have been on the rubber chicken circuit before any group that will hear you speak. What have you heard going across the five parishes?
Surprisingly, and this is the God's honest truth, it has been an overwhelming amount of support. I have been in every part of our five parish area, parish councils, school boards, chambers of commerce, rotary clubs. I have gotten endorsements that you can find on our website, renewal@fpjdc.org. When you see that, then you see how many organizations are out there that are actually backing this and know the value of it.
So have you encountered any opposition? And if so, what was it?
I've encountered a little bit of opposition online. We've had some online social media posts related to our tax, and most of the opposition has just been people who are anti-tax. I think they have a misunderstanding of how taxes work. I think they have a misunderstanding of how property taxes work versus sales taxes. But generally, I just think that they're anti-tax. But that's not the majority of people. For example, we had a post that had 300 likes and only 3 dislikes. But there was a few commentaries on there about how they were just not going to vote for another tax. And I just think that that's misinformation on what it's for and how it operates.
Of course, it's a renewal anyway.
It is a renewal. And the great thing is that in January, we made our 30th anniversary. So this center has been around for 30 years. This is not a new concept for the area. And before it opened in 1992, courts had to issue a summons to kids and cross their fingers that they show up for court. And that was kids accused of murder, armed robbery. And it's just unthinkable that that could actually happen in a modern society. But without detention centers, that's what happens in much of the areas of our state.
What else do you want to share with us?
I just want to share that the vote is April 27th, and I'd ask that everyone get out, consider what's at stake. Consider the fact that if you don't have a juvenile detention center in your area, law enforcement will not have a place to lock up kids that require that to keep the public safe. And the other centers in our state do not take kids from outside their area, just like Florida Parishes doesn't take kids from outside its area. So I encourage everyone to go out and vote and support us. You can find out more information at renewal.fpjdc.org. That's renewal@fpjdc.org.
Hi, I'm Trent Anthony with Monument Real Estate. After working several years in the real estate industry, I decided to serve the wonderful people of Southeast Louisiana by opening a locally owned company where each client is treated with a tremendous amount of respect and importance. Serving the North Shore, Baton Rouge, and New Orleans regions, Monument has the ability to broker all types of real estate transactions. Your real estate needs are very important to us, so let me or one of our team members help you make your mark with Monument Real Estate.